Okay, so we're looking at homework from section 3.4. This is question number 20. A warehouse employs 21 workers on first shift, 16 workers on second shift, and 11 workers on third shift. Eight workers are chosen at random to be interviewed about the work environment. Find the probability of choosing exactly five first shift workers. So we have to think about this very closely. It's not just choosing the five workers on the first shift. We also have to choose the extra three workers that are not part of the first shift. So the way that this fraction is going to look for our probability is it's the number of ways to choose the five workers that are on the first shift times the number of ways to choose the three that are not from the first shift. That's a direct result of the fundamental counting principle that says if you can do event A in m different ways and event B in n different ways, then the number of ways that you can do event A then B is m times n. So we're choosing the first shift workers, the five of those workers, and then we're choosing the three workers that aren't on the first shift. They're either on the third or the second shift. And then you divide that by the total number of ways that you could just choose eight employees from the warehouse without any restrictions whatsoever. Okay, so how do we do that? Well, there's 21 workers on the first shift, and we're choosing five. So that would be 21C5. There are 16 workers on the second shift and 11 workers on the third shift. That means there's 27 workers that aren't on the first shift. So for the second part, it would be 27C3. And then the number of ways that we could choose eight warehouse employees would be 48C8. When we expand these out into their fraction forms, we get 21 factorial over 5 factorial times 21 minus 5 factorial times 27 factorial over 3 factorial, 27 minus 3 factorial, divided by 48 factorial over 8 factorial, 48 minus 8 factorial, which simplifies to 21 factorial over 5 factorial times 16 factorial times 27 factorial over 3 factorial, 24 factorial, divided by 48 factorial over 8 factorial, 40 factorial. So if we kind of expand all these things out in all of their glory, in our first fraction in the numerator, we're going to expand the 21 factorial until we get to the 16 factorial that we can reduce from its denominator. For the second fraction, we're going to expand the 27 factorial until we see the 24 factorial. And then in the denominator, we're going to expand the 48 factorial until we see the 40 factorial. So we have two 16 factorials on top, two 24 factorials on top, two 40 factorials on top. All of those reduce away. But then there's more reduction that can take place. So in the first fraction in the numerator, the 5 and the 4 make 20, and those reduce away. The 1, 2, and 3 make 6, which reduce with the 18 to leave a 3. In the second fraction of the numerator, we have the 3 and the 27 reduce to leave a 9, and the 2 and the 26 reduce to leave a 13. In the denominator, we have the 7 and the 6 make 42. 1, 2, 3, and 8 make 48, so those reduce. Then the 5 reduces with the 45 to give us 9, and the 4 reduces with the 44 to leave us with 11. So in the numerator, what do we have left? Well, we have 21 times 19 times 3 times 17 times 9 times 13 times 25. And in the denominator, we have 47 times 46 times 9 times 11 times 43 times 41. When we multiply this out, we end up with 59,520,825 divided by 377,348,994. As a decimal, that's 0.1577341558, and rounded to three decimal places is 0.158. And that's your answer.